Good evening and welcome back to H.O. Clemens Arena. We are moments away from the opening tip. Arkansas Pine Bluff here on the campus of UAPB at the Hyper Complex on H.O. Clemens Arena floor here. UAPB and Alabama State, an old rivalry between these two teams. Always going down to the wire between these two, no matter where they play, whether it's in Montgomery, whether it's right here in Pine Bluff, or whether it's in the SWAC tournament. These two teams always seem to play down to the wire. And expect nothing less here tonight as Broughton took a spill here on the opening introductions. Hopefully he's okay. They do a lot of little chest bumps and hip bumps, and he hit the floor, and he's got a big smile on his face, so that's a good sign. Now they'll get together and do their little, I don't know what you call it, lean with it, rock with it. They'll do a little swaying back and forth, get everybody all hyped up and ready to go. We're moments away from the opening tip. Tim Stubbs, glad to be with you once again here live on KUAP 89.7 FM and tape delayed on UAPB television. Happy New Year as we are back in action in full swing. A rare Sunday night game. I was talking with Carl Wimper just a moment ago. He'll be back with us in action, I believe, for the next ball game as our killer commentator. But we were talking about this rare Sunday night ball game here at UAPB, and he said this is the first Sunday night conference game in school history. So definitely a rarity tonight. You see a lot of Sunday games around the nation, and a lot of women's basketball teams will play Sunday conference games around the country, but the SWAC very rarely does so. So this is usually a Saturday-Monday format, but this week, I believe the way New Year's fell, and we opened up, instead of on a Tuesday, we opened up on a Wednesday. It pushed everything back a little bit, so we have a Sunday and Tuesday matchup. Tuesday's matchup will be against Alabama A&M. Opening tip's going to go to Alabama State as we are underway. And nice little dish off the glass and good. Dump down was there by Brown, and Chantez Patterson lays it in. 2-0 Alabama State as we open up the ball game here. UAPB's first possession. Hammond to Kennedy. Kennedy had a game high 25 in that win against Valley here last Wednesday. Hammond will hold it out high for Pine Bluff. 18 on the shot clock as they set up their offense here. UAPB started that last ball game against Valley on a 19-0 run. Down to 8 on the shot clock. Backing his man down is Kennedy. A little fadeaway one-handed shot about 8 feet out on the right side. It's no good. Quickly back is Alabama State. Patterson works it around the perimeter. He's got it at the top of the key. Now left side to Brown. Brown looking down low to Page. Nothing there. UAPB good half court set. Broughton gets the start tonight. Here's Patterson driving baseline. Now he throws it away. Stolen by Hammond. On the break. 4-on-2. The lob and the dunk. Nicely done. The lob by Hammond and the finish. Big time by Devon Haynes. The lob and the jam. Tied at 2. As Haynes, along with Mitch Anderson, who's going to come off the bench tonight, two of the most electrifying finishers in the air in the SWAC. And you saw Haynes on one of them there as Alabama State gets the jump bucket underneath. They lead 4-2. Almost 2 minutes in here. Here's Haynes. Kicks it out. LaZavian Jackson, the sharpshooter for three. Yes, sir. LaZavian Jackson drills the three, and UAPB's first lead at 5-4, 2 minutes in. Alabama State's going to have to find him. He is a streaky shooter. Once he gets on, he really can light it up. UAPB with the basketball after the miss by Alabama State. Hammond's got it out high. 17-45 and counting. Just underway here. Broughton now to Haynes. UAPB up by one with the basketball. Here's Jackson again. He'll take another three. This time no good. Tipped out. And it's going to be Waters basketball for Alabama State. Patterson kicks it left side. Watts passes up the three. Steps up. 17-foot jumper is good. And Alabama State regains the lead 6-5. They'll push it ahead. Haynes now to Broughton. Just outside of the lane, right side. Top of the key, Hammond. Little stutter step, gets it to Haynes, shot up in the lane, off the glass and good. Shot clock is went out momentarily, got unplugged, I believe. One of the cameramen possibly could have bumped the cord there. But it seems like it's got a short in it anyway, as it easily gets knocked off. And Mitch Anderson is going to check into the ball game for the first time for UAPB, and looks like Haynes is going to come out for a moment. He's got four quick ones and a big time lob and slam dunk, and then a bucket inside. So he had six in the last ball game and four already tonight. Some pressure by UAPB as Mosley's checked into the ball game as well, and Kennedy took a seat. Hammond and Jackson all over Patterson. He needs some help, nearly throws it away, finding a man underneath Watts. He lays it off the glass, no good. Broughton clears the rebound for Pine Bluff. They'll kick it ahead. Mosley. Now to Hammond. Left side of the floor. Jackson. Hammond wants to drive. Top of the key, it's Broughton. He'll take the jumper. 18-footer is good. Daniel Broughton. He's got a nice shot from around 15 feet or so, and he knocked that one in. That's a good sign. Here's Patterson. Quickly ahead. Now they'll set it up. Half court set to the Hornets. Waters nearly got it stolen away by Jackson off the head, and they're going to say out of bounds. Last touch by Lazavian Jackson of Pine Bluff. 16:05 to go. First half, UAPB leading 9-6. Alabama State with the basketball. In the corner, passing up the shot was Patterson. Now he'll take the 12-footer. It's a line drive, flat shot. No good offensive rebound. Page kicks it back out. Waters, he'll take the 17-footer. Left side, no good. Offensive rebound. Stick back, no good again by Patterson. But he will draw the foul as he's frustrated. And he'll have two shots coming up after this media timeout. We'll step aside. 9-6, UAPB with the early three-point lead. 15:48 to play. First half, right back with more Golden Lion basketball after this timeout.
A boy born in Joplin, Missouri was fascinated by anything with wheels and a motor. The odds of him going on to fascinate millions with his talent? 1 in 260,000. The odds of this born racer having 157 career top 10 finishes in NASCAR? 1 in 125 billion. The odds of him winning both the Daytona 500 and the Brickyard 400 in the same year? 1 in 195 million. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism? 1 in 110. I'm NASCAR driver Jamie McMurray, and my niece has autism.
Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs.
Back inside of H.O. Clemens Arena as we come back, take a look at that Hammond to Haynes lob city finish there. Nicely done as Haynes threw it down on the alley-oop break, helping UAPB build this early 9-6 lead with 15:48 to go here in the opening half to the free throw line as we resume play here. It's Shontez Patterson, a 6'7", 190, redshirt senior from Detroit, Michigan, transfer from Troy University. Misses the first shot. He'll have one more free throw coming up. One more here for Mr. Patterson. And he missed both of them. Hammond the rebound. Hammond pushes it ahead. Lazavian Jackson. Jackson thought about the three. That time they get on him rather quickly. Mosley now to Hammond. Hammond driving. Now he'll kick it back out. Mosley looks for a screen. Now left side. Anderson dumps it to Kennedy. Shot up in the lane. Little one-hander rolls off the rim. No good. Alabama State to get it back. 5 minutes into the game, UAPB leading 9-6. Go Lions got off to that 19-0 start. The last game against Mississippi Valley State. Valley made a game of it late, but UAPB won the game by 10. There's a, or by 15 rather. There's a long, let's see, was it a two or a three? It was a three for Alabama State, so we're tied at 9. Kennedy, top of the key. Mosley. Now to Hammond. Hammond looking for the kick out. Anderson now to Jackson. Mosley. In the corner. Hammond. His long three in and out, no good. Patience by both teams there. Here's Patterson. He'll rise and fire for three, no good, but the tip back and bucket is good. That is 24, Stephon Brown, 6'4", senior from Detroit. 11-9 now, two-point lead for Alabama State. Their first lead since it was 2-0. Here's Mosley. Mosley, the drive right side off the glass, will not go. Got a good look at it, good try, but it just wouldn't go down. Alabama State gets it back up by 2. They get it inside. Now Patterson to take the 15-footer. Right side, no good. Rebound cleared by Kennedy for Pine Bluff. They'll push it ahead. Jackson. Inside, Mitch Anderson off the dump down by Hammond. Anderson's going to be fouled. Two shots coming up here for Mitch. Three subs getting set to check in for Alabama State. And Devon Haynes will check in for UAPB. Haynes, the transfer from Bowling Green. And Anderson's first shot is no good. 11-9, UAPB down 2, 13-16 to play here. Here in the opening half, Anderson to have one more coming up. And the second shot is good for Mitch. So it makes it a one-point lead now for Alabama State. Some pressure now by UAPB. Alabama State trying to beat it. Here's Patterson, finds himself open again. Another 15-footer left side, this time no good. Hammond wants to push it ahead. Haynes was wanting the lob. Hammond to Kennedy, and it's stolen. Stolen away by Philip Crawford, coming right at us here. Taking their time, holding it out high, left side. Denzel McDaniel now taking the jumper. Brown, let's see, no good, but the tip is there. Brown's going to get credited for the basket, so didn't roll out all the way. 13-10, three-point lead for Alabama State. UAPB with the ball here. Kennedy kicks it. Baseline. Anderson, we're going to have a blocking foul on Alabama State. Making the call, Teddy Valentine, one of the all-time well-known officials in college basketball history. We've done some national championship games, several Final Fours, all kinds of big games he's officiated. Well, he is here tonight. Now a little pushing and shoving going on with Kennedy, and Teddy Valentine's going to try to get him to settle down a little bit. And players tend to love games that he calls. He'll let you play, but he does a good job of mediating things before he doesn't have a quick trigger. Coaches tend to like him as well. That's the first time we've had Mr. Valentine here in Pine Bluff doing a game. Inside, Broughton goes up with the right hand. Nice soft touch, lays it up and in. 13-12. If they can get really, if they can get Broughton going, that's going to be a huge plus for this team. Inside, going up for the jam, missing it. Now blocked from behind Haynes, ball loose. And it's still on the floor, and they're going to have a, let's see, jump ball alternating possession, I believe. Yes, it is. It's going to be Pine Bluff basketball. bodies were all over the floor there. Alabama State was hoping for a foul call as ...11:54 to go, and should have been a media timeout probably there. We'll have one of the next dead ball. Here's Hammond. Out of Haynes. Mosley's got it. Mosley driving in the lane. His shot blocked. Daniel Broughton's going to go up, clean it all up, and lay it up and in. He's making his presence known early in this game. Almost a steal there. UAPB back up by one, 14-13. Thought about the three, passing it up was McDaniel. Now getting it inside for the easy two was Stephon Brown. 15-14, back and forth we go. UAPB taking their time. Left side, nothing there. Top of the key to Mosley. Mosley looks for a screen. Now Hammond flashing for it. They'll slow it up. Looking right side. Haynes thought about the shot. Now he'll just throw up a wild shot. Hits the side of the backboard. No good. Not a very good possession there. In transition, McDaniel gets it stripped out of bounds. Going to stay with Alabama State. And that'll send us to a media timeout. 10:50 to play, first half. Alabama State leading UAPB by one, 15-14. Right back with more Golden Lion basketball after this timeout.
When some people struggle with their mortgage payments, they become frozen, petrified, not knowing what to do. They do nothing. But the people who do something, the people who take action, are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
10:50 to play, first half, 15-14, one-point lead for Alabama State. As we are set to resume play out of the media timeout. It's going to be Alabama State basketball, and we resume play here. 29 on the shot clock. Boyd has checked in for UAPB. Also, Broughton, Hammond, Haynes, and Mosley in the game. Kick out. Long three right side. Will not go for Free Love. Rebound, Pine Bluff. Mosley pushes it ahead. Boyd's got it. Hammond takes the quick three right side. No good. Lost out of bounds. Looked like off of Alabama State. Instead, they're going to say off of Broughton. Don't know about that one. 10:32 to go. Alabama State's going to get it back. Leading by one. They'll set it up. Top of the key. Brown, now they'll work it around the perimeter. McDaniel. Here at the free throw line, looking at it is Jefferson. Now he's trying to turn it or dump it down low, and then turns it over. Hammond with the steal. Little spin move. Mosley up and under. Gets it to go. Tough shot in the lane. Nicely done. Mosley with the basket. UAPB back up by one, 16-15. Top of the key, McDaniel. He'll take the long three, and no good. Battle for the rebound's going to come away to Crawford as it was kept alive by Joshua Freelove. And good hands by Boyd, stolen away by Broughton. Broughton wants to push it. In transition, now Mosley gets it back. in the lane. Here is Broughton. He'll take the 15-footer up the step back and knocks it in again. 18-15, three-point lead for UAPB as Broughton is off to a great start. He's got 8 points here in the first 11 minutes of the game. Alabama State with the ball, down by three. And now a turnover out of bounds. So UAPB will get it back with 8:54 to play here in the first half, leading by three. Xavier Jackson in the ball game along with Mosley as Haynes will come out. Also Boyd, Kennedy, and Broughton in the game. Here is Jackson. Mosley now to Kennedy, down low. Broughton gets his man in the air, goes up for the shot, missed it, but he'll shoot two free throws. Daniel Broughton playing very well early on here in the first half. Two free throws coming up for Big Daniel. First shot coming up for Broughton is good.
And the first basket is good.
One more coming up here for Daniel. And rims out, no good. So one of two for Daniel. We've got nine in the game. Alabama State with the basketball here. Holding it out high is Joshua Freelove, 6'2 junior guard out of North Lauderdale, Florida. Getting it down low, turning, spinning. Page off the glass, no good. Broughton clears the one-handed rebound. Here is Mosley in transition. Little crossover, kick out. Lazavian Jackson thought about the three. Now step back. He'll take the three, misses it. And Boyd's going to get called for the reach in. Clock stops at 8:03 left here in the first half. UAPB leading by 4, 19-15. And Daniel Broughton will get a quick breather as he has played very well here in the first half. Haynes back in the ball game for Broughton. Golden Lions looking to trap, but that's going to leave a man open underneath and reverse layup. No good by Luther Page. UAPB's got it going the other way. Here is Haynes in the lane, shot up and good. Got a man on his hip, got position, and Devon Haynes, he's got six. Timeout on the floor called by Lewis Jackson. We'll keep it here. It's a 30-second timeout. 7:35 to play. The next dead ball will be a media timeout. But UAPB has opened up a six-point lead. That is their largest lead of the game, 21-15. 7:35 to go before halftime. A lot of things UAPB does offensively is predicated off of their defense. They love to trap out of their zone. And that's what they'll look to do here as well. You got two up top and then three back. 2-3, 3-2. And matchup zone, they'll trap out of it. In and out, no good on the three-point shot. He had a good look at it, did Bobby Brown. He missed it. Here's Mosley coming the other way. Lazavian Jackson to Kennedy. He'll take the three and hit. Terrell Kennedy. He's a big fella. He's slimmed down a bit, but don't let him fool you. He's got a smooth stroke from downtown, always has. And he connects there on that three, and UAPB's lead quickly is up to nine, 24-15. 6:55 to go before halftime, and a steal. Good hands by Jackson. Here's Mosley in transition, looking more and more comfortable in that point guard area. Here's Boyd, strong drive. He's got Haynes on the block, and he scores. Nice dribble drive by Boyd. Freshman out of Marion, Terrell, Arkansas, and dumps it off. And Haynes has eight in the first half. 26-15, 11-point lead for UAPB. Down low, getting position in the easy two is Stephon Brown. Lead back to nine. Mosley running the show from the point. Works it left side of the floor, picks up his dribble. Here's Kennedy now, left side of the floor, backing his man down. Wants to work baseline, gets underneath there, some contact, and out of bounds off of Kennedy. That's going to lead us to a media timeout. We'll step aside with 5:59 before halftime. UAPB taking a 9-point lead, 26-17 over Alabama State. Golden Lion basketball right back after this.
My sadness and depression grew out of giving myself to my career before I would give myself to myself.
I didn't want to tell my parents. I really didn't want to tell anybody, and I didn't. I shut down.
Giving voice to what you're feeling is part of the healing.
The healing is in me and can also be extended to others.
If you're strong enough to just open your mouth, that's all it takes.
Hi, I'm Terry Williams. Can I tell you that it is way past time for us to come face to face with the issue of mental illness in the Black community? Time for us to stop hiding it behind closed doors. Share ourselves. Healing starts with us.
5:59 left before halftime. UAPB leading by 9, 26-17. And the Golden Lions want to show some pressure here on the inbound. Alabama State's got it, coming the other way with it. Quickly ahead, McDaniel. Inside, Brown goes up with a little one-hand shot, and he's got it to go. 26-19 now, 7-point game. Mosley picked up by Waters, now goes around him. Nice dump down, and Kennedy, like maybe got a shot blocked from behind there. Well played, but not executed throughout. Alabama State's got it. Down seven, and it's going to remain seven as Patterson missed a shot, but gets the offensive rebound. Watts will take the three, left side, no good. Another offensive rebound. This one by Brown, the kick out. Another three, will not go. That one was missed by Waters, and Kennedy finally clears the board. Three offensive rebounds, but nothing to show for it for Alabama State, but a foul. They're going to get that one on Ryan Watts, 6'2", junior guard. 5:09 and counting. Here's Mosley, wants to push it ahead in transition. Goes all the way, draws contact, no call. And Alabama State's going to come back on the other end with it. A lot of contact. Top of the key, McDaniel, and a whistle, and this is going to be a hold out high, I believe, on Kennedy. Is Denzel McDaniel was making his move to the basket. Clock stops at 4:54. Actually, they got Mosley with the reach in there. Free love back in for Alabama State. Patterson now top of the key to Waters in the lane. McDaniel kicks it out in the corner. Freelove hits the jumper. It is a three. 3-point shot by Freelove has quickly made it a 4-point game. So UAPB's 11-point lead has been trimmed down to four with a 7-0 run here by Alabama State. With 4.5 to go before halftime. Haynes has position down low on a smaller defender. McDaniel just 6'3", the 6'8 Haynes is begging for it. Jackson, he'll take the three, right side, yes sir. His second three of the half, Lazabian Jackson. The 3-point sniper for UAPB connects on another. Lead back to seven, 29-22. get it inside. The kick out, Patterson. It should have been a foul, no call. Boy, they're really letting them play. Kick out, Freelove, he'll take the three, no good. Another offensive rebound. Now Freelove's going to get called for the charge. He missed the three, got it back, and then drove to the basket, and then Haynes set up nicely in the lane for the offensive foul called on Joshua Freelove. We'll step aside with another media timeout here. 3:50 remaining before halftime. UAPB 29 and Alabama State 22. Right back after this media timeout.
Yeah, I took a trip to Elkhart, Indiana today. Elkhart's a place that has lost jobs faster than anywhere else in America. In 1 year, the unemployment rate went from 4.7% to 15.3%. Companies that have sustained this community for years are shedding jobs at an alarming speed. And the people who've lost them have no idea what to do or who to turn to. They can't pay their bills, they've stopped spending money. And because they've stopped spending money, more businesses have been forced to lay off more workers. In fact, local TV stations have started running public service announcements that tell people where to find food banks, even as the food banks don't have enough to meet the demand. As we speak, similar scenes are playing out in cities and towns across America.
3:50 to play before halftime, and UAPB leading 29-22 with the basketball as we resume play here. Xavier Jackson will inbound it. Top of the key, spotting up for three was Jackson, and a rare miss for him tonight. Alabama State with the basketball, down seven. Right side of the floor, McDaniel. Picked up by Haynes, now wants to drive. Goes up off the glass, too strong, no good. Rebound, Mitch Anderson. Here's Hammond, top of the key, picked up by McDaniel. Xavier Jackson in the corner, does not shoot this time. Needs some help, wants to go baseline with it. Throws it off the side of the shot clock and out of bounds. So he's trying to throw it across court and hit the shot clock. Turnover gives it back to Alabama State with 3 minutes left before halftime. UAPB leading by seven. Alabama State with the ball. In the corner, Freelove. He'll take another three and misses again. Haynes up high for the rebound for UAPB. Hammond's got it coming the other way. In transition. In the corner, now down low, Kennedy. Haynes, he'll spot up for three, rims out on him, no good. Had a good look at it, didn't go down. Pushing it the other way, McDaniel wants to go all the way, gets it rejected out of bounds by Haynes. 2.5 to play before half. Still a 7-point lead for UAPB. And I mentioned before this game, this crew's going to let you play. A lot more physical. They do a lot of big Division I style SEC, Big 10, Big 12. ACC, Big East type games, and that's what you're seeing. It lets you play a whole lot more than the SWAC officials that we've seen in the past. And both sides, there's been some fouls probably they should have been called, but it's benefited both teams as they really let you play. A lot of reaching in there is Hammond. And that plays right into his hands. He loves to get right up in your jersey. And he's right there all over his man. Waters needs some help. Now they'll settle for the long jumper by Jonathan Jefferson, and he misses. Too strong. UAPB's got it. Hammond will come the other way. Two to play before halftime. UAPB by seven. Hammond works it left side of the floor. Now he'll just take the three and missed. Broughton, the offensive rebound, goes up strong with it and scores inside. Daniel Broughton back in the game and doing work. He's got 11. 31-22, lead back to nine for UAPB. More pressure. Patterson now to Jefferson. Needs some help and a steal. Good hands by Broughton. Deflected it right to Devon Haynes. Hammond will orchestrate from the left side of the floor, trying to get to Broughton again. Strong drive, the kick out. Mosley passes up the three, now takes the little leaner in the lane, and he'll draw the foul. Two shots coming up as that foul is going to be on Joshua Freelove. And Mosley will shoot two. Second personal foul, sixth team foul. I mean, we're not even shooting one and one yet. UAPB's only got three team fouls. Alabama State with just six. Very rare. I like the flow to it, though. It's a lot more fun to call a game like this and probably a lot more fun to watch a game like this with not many fouls called. 1:14 left before half. Mosley's free throw is short and off to the right. UAPB going to try to extend it to a 10-point lead again. They led by as many as 11. Trailed by as many as just two. Second shot for Mosley is good. So back to a 10-point lead, 32-22, with just over a minute to go before halftime. And now a turnover. Good pressure there by Haynes of UAPB. So now Hammond will be set to inbound it. Checking in for the first time is Trent Whiting, the freshman from Des Arc, Arkansas, is in for the first time here. Here's Mosley, beautiful move off the glass and good, going down the left side of the lane. Well, he's played well here in the first half as well. He's got five. Lead up to 12, that's a high water mark so far for UAPB. 12-foot jumper in the lane is good for Alabama State's Phillip Crawford. Here's Whiting. Strong drive, the little floater. He is hip-checked on the way to the basket and draws the foul. Nice strong move there for Whiting. And don't let the freshman fool you. 6'3", he can get up. Nice little floater there, and looked like maybe he was going to a little finger roll, maybe dunk it, but he kind of got hip-checked there. His legs cut out from underneath him and got bumped on the way to the basket, so he'll shoot a pair of free throws, the freshman from Des Arc, Arkansas. The southpaw, a little bit strong, misses the first shot. Jalen Floyd. Into the ball game. One more coming up here for Whiting. And rims out, no good, missed a pair. UAPB still going to show some pressure, however, as we approach 30 seconds left in the half. Shot up in the lane, will not go for Brown, and Whiting clears the rebound for Pine Bluff. They can hold for the final shot if they want to do so. UAPB leading by 10. They want more. Missing the three was Broughton. Whiting, the offensive rebound, nicely done. Goes up with the one-handed rebound. He gets a standing ovation from the crowd. They love that. Great hustle for Whiting. I told you he can get up. 5 seconds left. Crossover, the little teardrop, no good. And we are at the half. Entertaining first half comes to a close. UAPB 34. Alabama State 24, 10-point lead at the break. We'll have the second half coming up for you shortly.
See where the good goes at goodgoes.org.
Back back inside of H.O. Clemens Arena. We are set for the second half. Tim Stubbs, glad to be with you here courtside as UAPB is enjoying a 10-point lead. Now that we're set to inbound the basketball, start the second half. 34-24, UAPB by 10 at halftime, and we are underway here in the second half. UAPB and Alabama State. Alabama State with the basketball to start the second half of play here. Patterson's got it left side, trying to work it inside as they get it to Page. Page back out. Watts trying to go inside and stolen away. Good hands by Haynes. Page was trying to get it to Stephon Brown, and Haynes picks it off. UAPB's got their first possession coming up here in the second half. Daniel Broughton had a big first half as that pass is deflected off of a Hornet out of bounds. Going to stay with UAPB with 19 on the shot clock. Broughton had 11 at the break to lead the way. Leads all scorers in the game. Here's Kennedy now. Lazavian Jackson spots up for three. Will not go. Offensive rebound. Looks like Broughton got it. They're going to call a jump ball, alternating possession. It will remain with Pine Bluff.
Jump ball was called, possession remains.
It looked like George Avery working one of the officials over there. Thought Broughton clearly had it and was fouled on that before it was tied up. Here's Hammond. Left side to Jackson. Now trying to go inside to Broughton. Broughton getting double teamed. Now they'll get it back out. And Jackson throws it away. A little miscommunication. Hammond thought he was throwing it to Kennedy and instead went the wrong way. So the turnover will give it back to Alabama State. .19:05 to go, just a minute into the second half. Going up inside was Patterson, partially blocked, taken out of the air by Broughton. So UAPB will come away with it, leading 34-24. Hammond will hold it out high for UAPB. Looking down low, nothing there. Jackson was ready to shoot. Going up for the shot. Step back, 15-foot jumper. It's good for Daniel Broughton, who continues his hot shooting. He's got 13 in the game. Going down low. Turning, spinning, a little fadeaway. Foul is called on Broughton as Luther Page is going to draw the foul. 6'6", sophomore from Ann Arbor, Michigan. That's the home of the University of Michigan. Long ways from home down here. UAPB by 12. That matches their largest lead as Luther Page will toe the line for two shots here.
In for the Hornets, number four, Joshua Freelove.
One more coming up for Page. And he gets the roll. Lead back to 10. Some pressure here. Jackson ahead. Haynes goes up for the shot in the lane. Counted in one. Tavon Haynes gets the basket and a chance for a three-point play. He's got 10 in the game to join Broughton in double figures. And very active tonight. Those two have combined for 23 of UAPB's 38. So Haynes will toe the line, a 6'8", 215 junior, transfer from Bowling Green. He is out of Detroit, Michigan, and connects on the free throw, three-point play for Haynes, got 11 now. Lead up to 13, that's the high water mark for UAPB, 39-26. Waters trying to get in the lane, got a little too deep, and stolen away by Haynes. He's got about three steals here as well. In transition, Kennedy passes up to three and threw it away. He was getting ready to go up and shoot it. And right as he was doing so, he looked to pass it down low and his intended receiver cut the other way. Turnover gives it back to Alabama State. 17:50 to go, second half early on. Second half, UAPB leads by 13. Looking strong early in the SWAC season here. Getting it down low to Page. Page finds Freelove, who misses the layup, partially blocked. And finally, Luther Page gets the basket. But offensive rebounding, already 10 offensive rebounds in the game for Alabama State. That has hurt UAPB tonight. Mitch Anderson up off the bench. He'll check in on the next dead ball. Hammond has got it out high in the corner. Lazabian Jackson thought about the three now. Kennedy to Broughton. Broughton step back, 15-footer. Yes, sir. Why not? He is on fire. En fuego. 41-28. Broughton with 15 in the game. He's got about four just like that last jumper. Good defense. Hammond all over his man. Trying to go down low. Page, a little pump fake, and a lot of ball there, but Broughton tries to swat it away, and hitting the floor hard was Luther Page, and going to get a foul on Daniel Broughton. 16:50 to play. Early second half, UAPB leading by 13, 41-28.
Kevin Hampton, his first personal second team foul. 2-2 for the Hornets. Number two, Luther Page.
Free throws for Page. First one is good. Broughton and Hammond will check out for a moment. UAPB's got some depth. They got some players, I'm telling you. Broughton's going to stay in, so it's going to be Hammond and Haynes coming out. They have some depth. Can play a lot of players. 16:50 to go. UAPB by 12. Luther Page, one more free throw coming up. Second shot off the mark. No good. Rebound, Mitch Anderson. Fine bluff will bring it up, leading by 12. Mosley's got it. Anderson in the lane, deflected, stolen away. Quick trigger three on the other end. Waters bangs it in. And just like that, lead back down to single digits. 41-32. Long three, step back, yes sir. Anderson hits the three for UAPB to match Waters' three. Lead back to 12. Mitch Anderson, another streaky hot player, can get going. Kick out for three, left side, will not go. And look at Broughton up high for the rebound for UAPB. They want to push it ahead. Here's Mosley in transition. Lazabian Jackson, step back for three. Yes, sir. Lazabian Jackson, his third three of the game. And UAPB's lead has swelled up to 15, 47-32 with 15:35 to play. Top of the key, Alabama State's got it. Waters looking for a screen and a near steal. The overplay by Jackson leads to a wide open three. Freelove drains it. Joshua Freelove cuts it to 12 and a timeout called by Lewis Jackson. 30-second timeout, or is it? Well, first timeout of the second half before the media timeout is an automatic full timeout, so we will keep it here with 15:18 to go. The next dead ball will be a media timeout. For now, we'll keep it here. 47-35, UAPB by 12 with the basketball when we resume play. It was a 10-point lead at halftime. Golden Lions have built it up to 15, and then that last three by Freelove has cut it to 12. UAPB playing well here tonight. They won by 15 on Wednesday night to open up conference play. In that ball game, UAPB jumped out to a 19-0 lead. Just one of those unbelievable starts to a game. Probably the best start I've ever seen for UAPB to start a game since I've been here. Valley end up cutting it to three in the second half before UAPB went on another run to win it by 15. Well, the Golden Lions lead by 12 here with 15-18 to go with the basketball. Some pressure by Alabama State. Mostly to Jackson. Takes the three on the pull-up. Will not go. Left side. Rebound pulled down by Crawford for Alabama State. They'll push it ahead. Waters kicks it out. McDaniel thought about the three. Now Waters trying to go inside and tipped away and stolen by Broughton. In transition, Broughton in the corner. Jackson for three. It rims out. No good. Had a great look at it. Probably wishes to have that one back. Everything was in fluid motion. Broughton found him wide open in the corner and just didn't go down. McDaniel stolen away. Anderson, look out. Jackson, the lob, the slam, and the aerial assault continues. Jackson, this time it's Mitch Anderson getting him some. 49-35, 14-point lead. We saw Haynes earlier, and now Mitch Anderson gets into the action with the high wire act as he throws down the big two-handed slam off the lob. Timeout on the floor. A media timeout will step aside. The Golden Lions flying high here tonight. They lead it over Alabama State 49-35. Right back in a moment.
Coming home can be hard if you're a veteran of Iraq or Afghanistan. You may feel like you're all alone. But you're not alone. At IAVA.org, your fellow vets are all around you. Join our free online community. Get the resources you need. And connect to other vets who know where you're coming from. IAVA.org. We've got your back.
.14:05 to go. And the Golden Lions off to another fast start here in the second half, leading by 14. That steal and breakaway lob and dunk by Mitch Anderson. As UAPB leading by 14, 49-35, 14:05 remaining in the ballgame. Waters set to inbound it. He gets it back after he gave it to Freelove. They'll set it up. UAPB in their zone defense. They love the trap out of it. With Broughton and Anderson down low. Nice rejection by Mitch Anderson. Phillip Crawford tried to get a little position down low, and Mitch Anderson, a little return to center there. UAPB's got it. Mosley. Now left side to Anderson. Jackson, now to Mosley. A backdoor lob, and Mitch couldn't finish it that time. He tried to get it and lay it in softly. Wasn't going to try to dunk it, but almost another amazing play by Mitch Anderson there on the lob. Out of bounds off of off of Jackson. 13:20 to go. And UAPB leading by 14 as Alabama State inbounds the ball. Haynes and Whiting set to check in a moment. I mentioned earlier Whiting at 6'3". Actually, Whiting at 6'6". My apologies. Off the glass, the layup, and no good. On the run, look out. Anderson goes up with the left hand, and it will not go down, but he'll draw the foul and shoot a pair. Nice little dish by Mosley, and Anderson will draw the foul and shoot two there. UAPB just getting it done on all facets right now. 12:57 to play. Here in the ball game, UAPB by 14, looking for more. Mitch Anderson will shoot a pair. First shot for Mitch Anderson is good. Boyd is back in. As well as Whiting and Haynes. Jackson, Broughton, and Kennedy will all take a seat. And Anderson hits a pair. Mitch Anderson now with 8 points in the ball game. He's heating up. Lead up to 16 now for UAPB. Step back jumper will not go for Brown. They get the offensive rebound and then up high Haynes. Off the loose ball, snags it out, then he throws it away, and let's see, it's going to be Patterson with it for Alabama State. In the corner, Freelove, he'll take the three, will not go. Whiting trying to get the rebound, hits the little support beam underneath the basket, out of bounds, going to stay with Alabama State. UAPB still up by 16, 51-35, and we're going to have a foul here before the inbound. And they're going to get it on Boyd, I believe. Warren Boyd, 6'3", freshman guard out of Marion High School. Here on the inbound, driving, strong drive, right side, will not go for Brown. UAPB wants to push it ahead. Anderson was on a run out, they missed. Probably would have been a dunk. Look out, here's Haynes. He goes up strong to the basket, and he'll draw the foul and shoot two. Hard foul, but he'll shoot a pair of free throws. Haynes and Mitchell, well, they play above the rim, no question about it. Haynes' first shot coming up. Is too strong, no good. One more coming up. We got a substitution here. Ryan Watt's going to check in the ball game for Joshua Freelove. Second shot is good. Makes it 52-35, 17-point lead. 12 minutes to play. Next dead ball will have a media break. In the corner, three is blocked by Haynes. Boy, he can get up. Ryan Watts was going to jack up a three, and Haynes had... Now we got some pushing and shoving, some... An upset player, but we're going to have a media timeout. We'll step aside here. 11:54 remaining in the ball game. UAPB in control, leading by 17, 52-35 over Alabama State. We'll be right back. Welcome back inside of H.O. Clemens Arena. Tim Stubbs, glad to be with you here once again, courtside, as UAPB is playing well tonight. The Golden Lions leading Alabama State 52-35, a 17-point lead with 11:54 to play. And Alabama State set to inbound it. Throw it deep in the backcourt. And bringing it up is going to be McDaniel. The Golden Lions up to 48-49% now for the game as Alabama State throws it away. And holding Alabama State to 31% shooting. UAPB 7 of 13. A little bit of a bugaboo there from the foul line. Alabama State 3 of 6. Leading scorer is Haynes with 14. Now he's got it down low, trying to go up for more. He's going to go to the foul line. Haynes has 14 points, 3 rebounds. He's got 2 steals, a block shot, and an assist as well. And he'll have a chance to increase his game high 14. Daniel Broughton with 13 points, 8 rebounds tonight, and just 18 minutes of play. Mitch Anderson has 8 for UAPB. Lazavian Jackson has 9. He's got 3 three-point baskets. UAPB just 5 of 14 from downtown for the game as the first shot is in and out, no good. By Devon Haynes. He's now 2 of 4 from the foul line, but he's 6 of 8 from the floor tonight. Broughton 6 of 7. Those two have combined for 27 points and 11 rebounds, and they are 12 of 15 from the floor combined. That's dynamic duo, those two. But that time, Haynes did miss a pair of free throws. The UAPB in control, leading by 17. Alabama State with the ball. They'll hold it out high. McDaniel picked up by Mosley. Now inside, going up for the little hook shot off the glass with a left hand. Will not go. Was Page, but they get it back. Long three, left wing is good by Stephon Brown. Makes it a 14-point game, 52-38, 10:50 to play. Whiting to Anderson. Anderson, strong drive, pull up 15-footer, rims out, no good. Had a good look at it. He can get off his shot anytime he wants to. He elevates so high, loves to pull up and take that little 15 to 17 foot jumper, but that one was off the mark. Out of bounds, it will be UAPB basketball after the turnover by Alabama State, though. Mosley will bring it up. Here's Haynes, now to Mosley. Inside, Mosley finds a open Haynes. Haynes is fouled again as he'll go to the line for 2 shots. Those two guys just giving Alabama State fits tonight. Haynes and Broughton and Anderson. This long, lean, athletic UAPB basketball team is, they're gonna be a handful for a lot of teams this year. Two shots coming up here for Davon Haynes. First shot for Haynes is good. Gets the roll that time. Second shot is off the back of the iron, no good. So Haynes, the only flaw in his game tonight, free throw shooting. Nice dump down low. Page waits on his man to get in the air, and I believe Boyd's going to get called for the foul. And free throws coming up here for Alabama State with 10:04 to play. Going to get Warren Boyd with the foul. That's his third personal foul, the fourth team foul on UAPB. And to the line will be Luther Page. And four fresh starters getting set to check in. Kennedy, Hammond, Broughton, and Jackson for UAPB on the next dead ball. So Mosley, Boyd, Whiting, and Anderson will take a seat. But good minutes out of that quartet of players. Second free throw for Page, no good, and clearing the rebound was Kennedy for Pine Bluff. So UAPB up by 14 with 10 minutes to play. Hammond, top of the key now to Broughton. Right side, Lazabian Jackson passes up the three. Now he'll take the three and miss from the right wing. Offensive rebound by Kennedy, goes up and under, lays it up and in. Nicely done. Does that so well. And a whistle and a foul, some contact to the lane. Should send Ryan a watch to the line now for Alabama State. It's going to be on Lazabian Jackson. His second team foul, number five. And first shot is good for Watts. Good look there at Coach Lewis Jackson of Alabama State. One of the great scorers in SWAC history. Actually played against George Ivory back in the mid-80s in the SWAC. Of course, Jackson at Alabama State, George Ivory at Mississippi Valley State. Here's Hammond, holds it out high, picked up by McDaniel. It's a screen from Kennedy. Now Lazabian Jackson, UAPB up by 14 with the basketball, just over nine remaining. Hammond, the drive. On the baseline is Broughton. He needs some help. About to turn it over. Going to try to call a timeout. Did he get it? Whistle and a timeout called with just three on the shot clock. 9:02 on the game clock. We'll keep it here. UAPB will inbound it with 3 seconds on the shot clock. We resume play, leading by 14. We'll be right back here on Tuesday night. Instead of Monday night, a Tuesday night ball game against Alabama A&M. If UAPB can hold on and win this one, improve to 2-0, and boy, look for a sweep of the homestand against Alabama A&M on Tuesday night. That'd be an awesome way to start off SWAC play. The women were in action earlier, and they got a 5-point win against Alabama State, 68-63. So they are 1-1 in conference play now. Congratulations to Nate Kilbert and his staff and ball club for their first conference win. And his first conference win as a UAPB Golden Lion for Coach Kilbert. Here's Hammond, got to get rid of it. A little floater, it did hit the rim, and a whistle and a foul was called with one on the shot clock. Thank you very much. So Hammond's going to shoot two here. There's a little floater in the lane, and it did hit rim, but it's a moot point because he was fouled. He'll shoot a pair. Belling out UAPB with a tough shot there. That was only three on the shot clock when they inbounded it. And he got fouled with one on the shot clock as he just got the shot off before the violation. And the first shot is good for Hammond. 56-41. Tevin Hammond. Holmes Community College makes his hometown, rather, from Little Rock, Arkansas. And the second is good. Makes the second, 57-41. Kick out. Trying to dump it down low. Page off the glass, no good. Tipped around, and Lazabian Jackson has the rebound for Pine Bluff. They'll push it ahead, leading by 16 with 8:35 to play. I want to use the word timid. Hammond left side. Haynes. And it's going to be a block And that's going to be on Luther Page, right literally in front of the official. Could have reached out and touched both players. He was right in front of the plate. Ball rolls all the way to the other side of the floor. That's the 17th foul.
And for the Hornets, number 12.
It's going to be a 1-1, it looks like, for Haynes. Davon Haynes back to the line. I mentioned he's been very good from the floor tonight, but from the foul line, he's missed a few. So Haynes will toe the line here for a couple, or a 1-1 rather, and get first one, you get another one. That first one is always so big on that 1-1. So he'll take his time here. And missed another one. Off the back of the iron, no good. So Haynes has struggled from the foul line, a near steal. Look at Jackson, almost had the steal. Alabama State does get it back. Pull up, 17-footer is good. Jamel Waters connects on the long two. Almost turns it over, gets it back, and then sticks the jumper. 57-43, 8 minutes to play in the game. We'll have a media timeout on the next dead ball. Here's Daniel Broughton, gonna back down Page. Fadeaway 15-footer, nothing but net. How sweet is that? He's got a big smile from ear to ear. Broughton is having some kind of night. 17 in the game to lead all scorers is the Watson Chapel native, Daniel Broughton. Page gets a little push, shot up, point blank range, no good. Broughton clears the rebound. Double-double night for Daniel Broughton, 10 rebounds as well. 59-43, 7:20 to play. UAPB leading by 16. Here's Jackson to Hammond. And a travel. He wanted to pass it to Broughton, and then he's going to throw it to Jackson instead, and he turns it over. So we will step aside with a media timeout. 7:12 remaining in the game. 59-43, UAPB in control, leading by 16. Back in a moment.
When some people struggle with their mortgage payments, they become frozen, petrified. Not knowing what to do, they do nothing. But the people who take action are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
This is one amazing truffula tree. Can you imagine a place where these grow everywhere? Yes, it's called The Forest, a magical place to enjoy with your family. So discover The Forest and explore all the wonder that's there. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
7:12 remaining. 59-43, all UAPB here, leading by 16 in the second half. As we get down to the final few minutes of the ball game, whistling a foul in the lane before the shot. That was Philip Crawford who was fouled in the lane there, and they're going to get Daniel Broughton. Just his second tonight, and that's a key part of Daniel's game, is keeping him out of foul trouble. And you get this type of crew here tonight that will let you play, and it's no coincidence Daniel's had a big ball game, 17 points.
Tell LaRon to take that mic from second.
For Broughton, 10 rebound, double-double night. And three-point basket is good by Patterson for Alabama State. Cuts the lead to 13. Here's Hammond, got a man all over him. Needs some help. And Hammond gets it finally to Kennedy. Here's Lazabian Jackson. Now back to Hammond. Hammond working right side of the floor. And Kennedy's going to get it. Kennedy, strong drive. Goes up to the basket. They're going to wave it off. And We got one official with a block and one official with a charge, it looks like. But the charge is going to overrule it. So 6:14 to play. Kennedy is going to commit his first personal foul, and team foul number 7. Alabama State will inbound it, coming the other way, down by 13. Waters looking down low, nothing there. Picked up by Hammond. Boy, Hammond is all over him. And almost had a steal. Poked it away and went right off the shoulder and out of bounds of Mosley. Mosley and Hammond, well, they are cat quick. Hammond loves to play defense. He will get right up in your jersey and get after you, no question about it. Stripped, stolen away, good hands again. Here we go, Mosley. Mosley, a little lean and score. Got a little lean into the body and got just enough separation to get the shot off, lays it off the glass and good. 61-46, UAPB by 15. Waters the ball fake, dumps it off down low, and partially blocked as Crawford went up with it, no good. And Mosley will control the basketball. So Mosley will bring it across the timeline with UAPB up 15, just over 5 minutes remaining in the contest. Mosley still holds his dribble, a little crossover, picked up by Waters, now stolen away. Waters picks his pocket. He wants to go all the way. It's blocked, but Waters is fouled and getting a little chippy down there with Waters and Mosley there. Ten to play. Free throws coming up here for Jamel Waters. Alabama State down 15 at the free throw line. First shot for Waters is good.
In for the Hornets, number 2, Luther Payne.
Second one off the front of the rim, no good. Broughton clears the rebound. 5 minutes to go, UAPB with the ball, leading by 14. Some pressure here by Alabama State. Kennedy ahead to Mosley. They'll slow it down. Kennedy looking down low. Here is Broughton. This time the jumper is an air ball. Saving it out of bounds was Hammond, and knocked out of bounds by, let's see, last touch by UAPB. So Alabama State to get it back. With 4:47 remaining and down 14. So Broughton's going to check out of the ball game, but he has had a stellar performance tonight. 17 and 10 for Daniel. Double-double. Here's Waters flying in the lane. Beautiful little teardrop. Counted and one. So strong drive to the basket there for Waters. He'll toe the line, a chance for a three-point play. Now checking in for the first time. Hammond's going to take a seat. Checking in for the first time for UAPB is Chandler Savage, 6'1", sophomore guard right here out of Pine Bluff. First shot, or rather a three-point play. Only shot is good by Waters. Lead down to 11 here. Boy, there's some contact, and finally a foul called as Lazabian Jackson hits the deck, tried to split the double team there, and hits the floor hard. So Jackson's going to go to the line here, and he'll shoot a 1-1. That's the first on Stephon Brown, and that's the 8th. Team foul on the Hornets. Lazabian Jackson, big free throw coming up here. Let's see if. And he does hit it. Let's see if the Golden Lions can make some free throws down the stretch. They've missed a few here in the second half. One more coming up for Lazabian Jackson. In and out, no good. Haynes tried to save it, knocked it out of bounds. 12-point lead for the good guys. 4:31 left. See if UAPB can close it out. They've been very dominating at times here tonight. Long three, left side, will not go for Patterson, kept alive by Alabama State. Top of the key, Waters back to Patterson. He'll take another three and misses again. Battle for the rebound. A whistle and a foul is going to be on UAPB. Let's see who they're going to get here, Jackson or Kennedy. It's going to be on LaZabian Jackson over the back.
Foul on LaZabian Jackson.
That's the third on LaZabian, and team foul number 10 on UAPB. 4:14 to play. Golden Lions up by 12. Luther Page trying to cut into that 12-point deficit. First shot is good. One more coming up here. And no good on the second. Jackson clears the rebound for Pine Bluff, picked up instantly by Waters, and now Mosley will bring it up with free love all over him. Nice little stop and go by Mosley, gets it to Haynes inside. Haynes got his man in the air, draws the foul, and he'll shoot two. With 3:59 to play, that's going to lead us to a media timeout. We'll step aside here, our final media break of the game. 62-51, UAPB by 11. They'll shoot free throws when we come back. 3:59 to go. You're listening and watching Golden Lion basketball. Right back in a moment.
Now, come on.
Hang on,
2 seconds.
Hang on,
just stand
still.
Stand still.
This is insane.
Just 1 second.
Come on. He's done.
Okay, go.
Boys, hang on!
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just as you are.
Over 13 million people are affected by famine, war, and drought in the Horn of Africa.
When you hear about suffering on this scale, you feel powerless.
But there's hope, because saving lives doesn't take a lot.
It just takes a lot of us.
Text a donation of $10, but do more than donate. Forward the facts to everyone you know.
Forward from our site.
Forward on Facebook.
And forward on Twitter.
We are the relief.
.359 remaining. UAPB trying to go to 2-0 in conference play after their 15-point win against Valley last Wednesday. Up by 11 here with 3:59 to go against Alabama State. We'll have Alabama A&M here on Tuesday night. Women's action tipping off at 5:30. The men will play 30 minutes after that one is over. Haynes to the line here to shoot a pair. And he knocks this one in. Had missed three in a row before that. He was just 3 of 8 tonight from the foul line, but he's got 15 points, 6 of 8 from the field. Struggled from the line, now 4 of 9. One more coming up here for Devon Haynes. And this time he knocks in a pair. It's more like it. And now on the inbound, we're going to have a whistle and a hold, I believe, on UAPB before they can. Alabama State tried to inbound it. I'm going to get Hammond on the hold. So two shots coming up, double bonus. The third on Hammond.
Shooting two for the morning. Number 12, Jamel Waters.
UAPB tonight shooting 49% from the field, 23 of 47. We'll take that pretty much every night of the week. First shot is no good by Waters. They've held Alabama State to 18 of 55. That's 33%. The Golden Lions have struggled from the line. They are 13 of 24. Second shot is good by Waters. 64-52, 12-point lead for UAPB with the ball. Mosley holds his dribble. Now it's Kennedy. Kicks it out. Haynes. Mosley in the corner. Hammond. He'll take the 17-footer. Will not go. Offensive rebound by Kennedy, but they're going to say he pushed off. He didn't like it, and I don't blame him. Let him play all night, and then things get tight, interestingly enough. 64-52, 3:31 to play. UAPB by 12, and at the foul line, shooting two, Stephon Brown. And first shot for Brown is no good. Too strong. One more coming up for Brown. And he missed them both. Lazavian Jackson up high for the one-handed rebound. Mosley will bring it up to Hammond. 3:20 to play. Here's Kennedy. Now they'll set it up. Hammond top of the key here. 64-52, 3:15 to go. UAPB with the ball up by 12. Hammond, strong drive. He's going to go all the way backside and lays it off the glass for the easy layup. 66-52, up 14 now. Quick trigger three, left side is good by Freelove. Back to an 11-point game, and a whistle and a foul on Alabama State. And that's going to be on Stephon Brown, I believe. It's the 10th foul actually going to be on McDaniel. That's his third, but two free throws coming up. Double bonus now for UAPB. So it'll be two shots here for Tevin Hammond. And Hammond's first shot is good. One more coming up. Hammond now with five in the ball game. He's got three in a row himself after the layup a moment ago. Lead back to 12 now. Make it 13. Hammond connects on both. 2:50 to go. UAPB by 13. And you got a stoppage in play on the inbound. Stephon Brown set to inbound it, but not sure what happened there. Waters will let it roll about 20 feet before picking it up. Now nice pass inside, and we're going to have a charge, I believe. Yes, sir. Lowered his shoulder, and Luther Page is going to get called for the charge.
Offensive foul called on Luther Page.
That's the fourth on Page. So 2:46 to go. UAPB will get it back, leading 13. And the ball boy will wipe up the floor after those bodies hit the floor with a little bit of sweat. They clean it up, ready to go here. Kennedy needs some help, dribbled it off his foot and out of bounds. Got ready to turn up the sideline with it, and when he did so, he dribbled it off his foot. It's going to give it back to the Hornets with 2:43 to play. Kick out. McDaniel take a long three, knocks it in. Nothing but net deep in the corner. Going to have a reach-in foul on Denzel McDaniel after he hit the three, commits the foul. Lead down to 10 now, closest Alabama State's been in a while. Largest lead of the game was 17 by UAPB. They led by 10 at halftime, and that's where we are now with 2:34 to play. It's going to be Hammond. He just made two free throws. He scored UAPB's last 4 points. He's back at the line here for two more. And he's got another.
And he makes the first.
Daniel Broughton up off the bench, set to check in. One more coming up here for Tevin Hammond. And his first miss from the foul line. 69-58, UAPB by 11. Here's Freelove, slams into Kennedy, and they're going to have a whistle and a charge on Freelove as Kennedy was camped out in the lane, and kind of a silent whistle there by Teddy Valentine. But it was a good call. It's a second on Freelove. Player control foul in this end, so no free throws. 2.5 to play. Teddy Valentine there talking it over with Coach Lewis Jackson, but I will tell you, Coach Lewis Jackson, one of the coolest customers you'll ever meet. Off the court, really nice guy, just super, super cool fella. Great player in his own right when he played, and a heck of a coach as well. Always a lot of respect for he and his ball club. Here is Broughton. He took the three that time. He can make that, but shot the air ball on that one. Long three. McDaniel rims out this time. No good. Haynes up high for the rebound. He wants to push it. Now he'll slow it down and get it into the hands of Mosley. 2 minutes remaining. UAPB leading with the basketball. 69-58 Golden Lions. Mosley has it out high, drives in the lane, now gets it to Broughton. Broughton goes up off the glass, scores it inside. Mosley orchestrated it, and Broughton is rewarded with 2 points. 19 points for Broughton in the ball game now, leading all scores. And that was almost an up and down there by McDaniel. Then he gets his pocket picked by Kennedy, stolen away. So UAPB will have the basketball, leading 71-58 with 1:15 to play. Mosley will continue to hold it out high with the dribble. Now in the lane, a nice pass. Broughton goes up, easy two off the glass. Again, Mosley just making it happen, breaking down the defense with his dribble. Easy two for Broughton inside, nicely done. 73-58, under a minute to go now. Waters for three, no good. Mosley again will bring it up for UAPB ahead. Haynes, he wants to throw it down, and he's fouled on the way to the basket, hits the floor hard. It's an intentional foul called on Alabama State. Haynes was getting ready to rock the rim and hit the floor pretty hard there. He seems to be okay, but an intentional foul called. With 48.6 remaining, UAPB leading by 15. And flagrant one called, and that's the fifth on Denzel McDaniel. And Broughton's going to check out of the ball game again, but he's had a great night to Daniel Broughton. So Haynes will, I believe, shoot two and get the basketball back. Maybe. Everybody's back on the other end of the court here, but I think that is the case. First shot coming up for Davon Haynes. Rims out, no good. He's frustrated tonight with his free throws. You can read his body language. He'll have one more coming up. And off the front of the iron, no good. UAPB will inbound it with 48 seconds to go. One of those nights for Haynes, but he's had overall a very good game, but just struggled from the line tonight. Here's the handoff to Jackson. 40 seconds remaining in this one. UAPB with the ball, leading 15. Hammond holds it out high, picked up by Freelove. Hammond with the drive, the little floater will not go. Almost tipped in by Haynes, but pulled down by Alabama State. They'll push it ahead. Layup, missed it badly. UAPB's got it. They'll hold it with 15 seconds left, can dribble out the clock. And Coach Lewis Jackson instructs his team, do not foul, and the Golden Lions are going to improve the 2-0 in conference play. Wins over Mississippi Valley State and Alabama State. That's a winner, folks. 73-58 UAPB. Another dominating performance. Two 15-point wins to start conference play for the Golden Lions. Off to a fast, effective, impressive start in conference play. A clean sweep tonight on this rare Sunday night swaction here in Pine Bluff. The Lady Lions beat the Lady Hornets by 5, and then the men did the same, but they won in convincing fashion by 15 over Alabama State. Say a special thanks to our crew tonight, Finley Hill back in the KUAP studio. For Randy Kelley, Shelley Roby Ingram, Kendra Cole, Nikita Goins, Devin Killingsworth-Wells, Corbin Howard, and Archie Howard, our crew tonight here on UAPB TV. The Golden Lions win it by 15, improved to 2-0 in conference play. Next up here Tuesday night, 5:30 tip for the women. The men will play 30 minutes after the conclusion of that ball game. So another game, another winner for UAPB in convincing fashion tonight over Alabama State. I'm Tim Stubbs saying so long for now. Until next time, go Lions. Good night.